And Paul says, rejoice always, pray without ceasing, in everything give thanks, for this is the will of God, and do not quench the Spirit. And where is that? Right here. In 1 Thessalonians 5. And you squirm and wiggle and fidget. You did a good job on that one, God. St. Luke's Lutheran Church, Galatia, New York. You couldn't have made a prettier day. The gazebo. Martha Rabbit, hook up to the battery charger, the big one, and be infused with health, vigor, vitality, renewal, rejuvenation. Martha Rabbit in New Rochelle, New York, at Christ United Methodist Church, North Avenue. There's Hedvig to pick me up. I forgot to videotape the poinsettias and Franklin III and his mother.
Isn't it beautiful, folks? You see the blue sky and the great big green plants and the green grass. Isn't it beautiful? It's Sunday, October 12th, and it is a sunny day. I wanted to ask you this. Have you heard anything from God that will help me? What have you heard recently? The most recent thing that I have heard and I'm to share with you is this. Get up an hour early in the morning or a couple hours earlier and hook up to the battery. Hook up to the battery charger. And it begins to flow. All the strength, all the happiness, all the joy, all the attainment, all the richness, all the wealth, all the success, it begins to flow. And all the health. It just flows and flows and flows and infuses and transfuses until you're full, until you're perfect. And I'm praying, still praying for Alan. I'm still praying particularly for Martha Rivette in New Rochelle. Christ United Methodist Church on North Avenue, New Rochelle. I'm praying for Martha Rivette. She's not able to pray for herself, folks. So we have to do it for her. We have to hook her up to the battery. And we have to give her that transfusion. That's a good thing, isn't it? It's 2 minutes to noon, and we will rejoice about something. 15 things at noon. See, to me, there was something in here to tell you. Thank you, Joseph Cronin and Diane Bennett, for trying to resolve the mishandling of a chat with Glendora on Cablevision NASA. It was bad. Cablevision NASA played the same program 7 times when they had a stack of programs that were just as good or even better. They didn't play at all. And then they got mixed up with the time slot, and they took the time slot from 9 p.m. Friday nights and put it over to 10:30 p.m. Friday nights. That's a rank violation of public access law, federal, state, and municipal. Public access is to be administered on a first-come, first-served basis. Glendora was first-come in 1993, and whatever time slot she was given, it was hers forever. These people have been sued, they could be sued, and they could go to jail. But we don't have any courts to sue them in. The courts are totally eroded into flat nothing. It's a puddle. Everything is perfect, folks. Everything is perfect. No running, no cunning. No running, no cunning. Paul says to you, let you and I do this together. I've been doing it and it's fun. You warn the unruly. I got unruly myself, and I apologize for that. Warn the unruly. This comes from 1 Thessalonians, 5th chapter, about the 14th verse, I guess. Warn the unruly. Comfort the faint-hearted. That would be my third bit. Uphold the weak. Be patient with all. I just on that one, I apologize. And I'll take a hit for it. And I am taking a hit for it. And do not let any person render evil for evil. That happened in the laundromat. This man who was helping me with one of these great decanting machines. Then later on, he said to me angrily that they charged $1.25 extra for hot water. And he says the water was cold. I tested it. Well, I doubt that it was $1.25. I think it was $0.25. And I don't see how you could test it because the mint's cold. And it's not a top loader. You can't lift the top. It's a side loader. You can't lift it. So the water may well have been hot to wash and when it started. So I said, let me go and tell the owner. I know the owner, Bob's from Queens. I know his two sons. And I think they are his people. Oh, no, no, don't go tell him. I put signs on the two washers. He says, and now you... And I'm going to tell the Better Business Bureau. That's what I'm going to tell. So he was bitter, and he kept resisting my going to see the owner. So I went to see the owner anyhow. And Larry was there. The owner was out. And Larry said, you have trouble with hot water, to the man. And then he told the stories. And Larry went out. He came back with the money. Well, this man was a happy man in the whole wide world. Why, this was the greatest world there is. Everybody in it was perfect. Why, this was... So that was a good application, number 5 here. Do not render evil for evil. Like Cablevision. You know, Cablevision messing up the time and messing up the program that should be played is evil. Rendering evil for evil is the punishment. But then I don't know this. However, I'm not learning. And then, number 6. This is a long list and a whole lifetime list that Paul gets you in 3-4 graphs. In 1 Thessalonians 5:14. Next one, number 6 is, rejoice always. How about that? Number 7 is, pray without ceasing. Oh, that's a good one. Please do that. And number 8 is, in anything you do, give thanks. Number 9 is, for this is the will of God. And number 10 is, do not quench the Spirit. What's quench mean? Flatten. Obstruct. Let's see. Abolish. Quash. Sin. Do not quench the Spirit. I'm going to the Joy Book. The Joy Book is the most fun. It's an email to God. The Joy Book takes the email from God, and that's what you're going to do next. And then the Joy Book sends the email to God, kind of writing down what you have. These are very nice minutes. I haven't talked about this for a long time to you. Do you see them? You see the green minutes? Those are the minutes when you just go about doing your work with your hands or whatever. And you just make sure that you stay away from... Well, you just make sure that your thought is pure, that you stay away from ugly, second-level, trivial, negative. No negative, second-level, trivial, ugly. So you get a green triangle for that minute. You get a red triangle when you think about how great God is for a minute. You get a blue triangle when you transfer that greatness of God to somebody like Martha Rivette, who needs resuscitation. What she needs is this. Wait for the manure truck to go by. I'm telling you that those cows, poor things, stand in urine and feces all of their lives. Don't you have anything to do with eating meat? Not only for that reason, but for the reason of the carcinogens that are put into their food. to bring up false size and muscle. And worst of all, don't eat them because of the cruelty. Do not be cruel to animals. All creatures of our God and King, lift up your hearts and let us sing. Just be kind, stop the cruel. Thou, cows and pigs, leave them alone. The horses, hens, and turkeys too. Save the fish. Just be kind, stop the cruel. Alleluia, alleluia. That's a made-up song based on St. Francis of Assisi. St. Francis of Assisi. Did I tell you about the man who...